So first of all, to clarify, an endotoxin test is not a sterility test. I often get that question from our customers when they're performing a sterility test, and they'll ask, is an endotoxin test a sterility test? I have to explain to them, no. But we do perform that test in conjunction with the sterility test because it measures the level of pyrogens within the formulation. That's particularly important when you have an intrathecal formulation that's going into the patient's spine. It can cause severe damage if that level of pyrogen is not measured appropriately. That's why we perform an endotoxin test. To explain more about the endotoxin test, I'll turn it over to our microbiologist here at Eagle.
Because of the significance of how harmful potentially bacterial endotoxins can be on humans and animals, especially if you're producing medical devices that or injectables that come into contact with the bloodstream or spinal fluid, it's essential to test your sample for bacterial endotoxins. So there are a complex of lipopolysaccharides, which are gotten when the cell lyses. Mostly they're gotten through contamination from water, so during prepping and making sterile injections as well. Sterilization is not the same as endotoxin-free. Even though a sample might be sterile, it does not mean that it's endotoxin-free. And because of the potential effects on human health and animals as well, you essentially want to make sure that your product is endotoxin-free as well. Per USP, all Category 2 injectables, that is compounded sterile preparations, and also those assigned with the BUD, or sterility testing as well, have to be tested for endotoxin. So during the test, we actually use an LAL test, which is a limulus amebocyte lysate test. And essentially, the limulus polyphemus horseshoe crab has these amebocytes, which we extract from them. And upon contact with endotoxins, it causes a coagulation reaction. So the test itself, the instrument, measures when the coagulation reaction occurs. And with that, we can actually detect up to 0.001 EUs per mil, and making the test very specific and sensitive. We use the average body weight, the average patient body weight, and max dosage per hour to calculate the endotoxin limit allowed for a sample, and this is how we determine if it passes or fails as well.
For more information about USP 85 endotoxin tests, feel free to reach out to us, 800-745-8916 or www.eagleanalytical.com.